I have 5 tips to improve your photography and probably change the way you think about photography and your camera. Hello, Kent Weekly here with another photography tip. Well, actually today I've got 5 tips for you, all designed to help improve your photography. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, tip number 1, study. Ooh, I know that sounds horrible. Reminds you of school and all those monotonous hours endlessly preparing for tests. No, not like that. You're probably already doing this type of studying. What I'm talking about is find the photographers that you like or find images that you like. They could be in magazines, they could be on blog posts, they could be anywhere. Start collecting them. If you've got the ability to pull them out of magazines, start collecting those images and keep them around so you can look at them on a regular basis. Perhaps set up a Pinterest page and start marking the images that strike your fancy that you like. And then start studying them. Look at them. Question yourself, what is it about these images that's really attracting you? Is it perhaps the color, the patterns, texture, subject matter, composition? What is it that you like about those images? And then start trying to decide how you can mimic that. Don't just copy it, but mimic it. Maybe there's some particular style that you're seeing that involves very, very asymmetrical compositions as an example. Well, perhaps you can start figuring out ways of making images that mimic that and see what kind of results you get. So tip number 1, study. Tip number 2, reduce. Okay, this one's a little counterintuitive, but what it does is it makes you focus and makes you sharp. Reduce when you go out for a shoot. Reduce down to 1 camera, reduce to a small memory card, and reduce the number of shots that you take, and reduce the amount of lenses that you use. So in other words, use 1 lens. Even if you have a zoom lens or a telephoto lens, keep it fixed in 1 location. If you have some gaffer's tape, tape it. So maybe you've got it set at 70 millimeters. Say you've got a 70 to 200 millimeter lens, you set it at 70 millimeters, tape the lens so you can't change it, you can't zoom in and out. And force yourself to work under those restrictions and you're gonna see all kinds of great improvement in your images. It's also gonna force you to see things that you might not see normally when you're just moving around quickly, switching between all of your equipment. Okay, tip number 3 is always keep your camera with you. Now, the obvious benefit of this is that if you see something that's worthy of photographing, you're ready. But the side benefit that's kind of hidden is that if you're aware of the fact that you have your camera with you, you're going to be most likely thinking more often about opportunities to create and make more images. It's that simple. Keep your camera with you. Tip number 4, use a tripod. Yes, you're going to be required to use a tripod when you get into slow shutter speeds, especially night photography and things of that nature. However, besides the added benefit of having great sharp images all the time by using a tripod also forces you to slow down and really look at the scene, compose what you want to have in your image, remove what you don't want, and gives you the time to easily look all around inside your viewfinder and make sure that's really the scene that you want, and make very subtle, deliberate adjustments as you go. So use a tripod. Tip number 5, go beyond. You've made a great shot, looks fantastic. Perhaps you've done this in a very short amount of time. This is pretty common. People go up, they get a good image, they're happy, they're done. Well, go beyond that. Explore. Go look for different perspectives. Get down low, go up high. Look up, look down, look all over the place. Look for different angles, different compositions. Look for different light. Maybe you can backlight your subject or sidelight it. If sidelighting is going to increase your visibility of texture and backlighting is going to give you more definition of space, you've got all kinds of opportunities. Is there a different way of dealing with this subject? Become inquisitive, explore, and go beyond the first shot that you make that you're happy with. So there you have it, 5 tips to help improve your photography. Leave me a comment either on YouTube or on my blog and let me know if you currently use any of these techniques or if you found any of them interesting enough to try out. And let me know how it goes for you.